So as you guys can see, I have my workout calendar in this daily view within our daily planner. And that's something that we're going to strive towards. But before we get into that, let's showcase to you guys what I have for my little running calendar slash workout calendar here. So I was training a lot for track and field back when I did it. And actually, if I go back a few months here, I was doing a lot of tracking of how my training log was supposed to go, what I was doing outside of everything. And you can see there's a lot of different properties in here, and it's going to be different a little bit than what I have, the one I'm going to create in this template video. However, I did want to showcase to you guys what I had going on here. As you can see, there's like a whole planned mileage versus actual mileage, workout minutes, all those sort of things. And we're going to be able to do all of this within Notion, and there's actually a nice sync that you can set up with Strava, which I'm going to dive into in this video as well. So furthering Notion from scratch, let's go to this Notion homepage here, and let's have a nice little page set up. So I'm going to drag a block here so I get some room. Make some more room, actually, because why not? I don't really feel like cramping things up. So let's do slash page. And then we can make it a workout calendar. Add a little icon here. Running. Then do slash calendar inline. Make this guy full width if it is what you want. Workout calendar. Then we can go to this Notion homepage. Running, make a little emoji here. Copy the workout calendar link. Put it on the synced block. Copy the synced block, sorry about that. And then what you want to do is take a block, take this, bring it all the way up there. And then I always like adding a little extra space, so we can just drag this guy up here and we're good to go. So the properties that you're going to have for this inline calendar are going to be different than what I had. So I'd like to keep the date. It is a calendar. However, I'd like to switch this to a select workout type. We're going to do probably the most basic ones, right? Cardio, strength, so like lifting, or calisthenics, and then core. So core is obviously like abs and such. So if we get those out of the way, now we can do something that's pretty universal, which is something to keep track of, is workout time. Like how long the elapsed time was. Then we can do planned distance, make that a number property. Actual distance, make that a number property. And then if we keep this trend up, we can add two more final numbers. And this one is going to be called planned reps, actual reps. So it's the planned and actual repetitions that you have for your workouts. And this is kind of all you really need for the properties that you're going to make. But the templates that you can create out of this are nice, in my opinion. So if we get a core template, let's see if abs works now. Let's just do, just trying to find an emoji for this guy. Let's just do the flex one, and then we'll adjust from there. We have core training, create a template. Oh, did that one backwards. We have core training. We can kind of make this the template here. And then we can do a little H3 and type workout details, put a little divider, put a little to do. That's what I like to end up putting down there. So anytime you want to make a core training, then it'll look like this. Now what I'm going to do really quickly is just duplicate this guy, change it to strength. Remove that cover. I don't really care about covers for stuff like this. Change it to lifting. And then we can change this to strength. Change this guy to cardio. Change this to cardio. Change this to running. And then I have three nice little templates that can give you your workout details really quickly. And you can pick from these when you're creating different templates. And if we want to as well, we can add the different elements that we want here. So workout type would be maybe fine. Because you might be writing the titles out to do your exact training or something like that. Or you want to put your plan distance, whatever it is, you can put the properties there as well. So let's do some examples of training here. So core training, planned reps, I want to do like 5. And what does that mean? I'll do like, for me, this is like my daily habits, right? So I personally do about 5 times 30 second planks. Sometimes I just do it all in a row, to be honest, but 5 times 30 second plank repetitions. And then if by the end of the day, say I actually hit the 5, or I'll do 6 for this circumstance, it's the planned versus the actual repetitions. Then if I go to today as well and do some strength training, you can put daily push-ups, planned reps 100, actual reps 150. Then lastly, we can do cardio training, 3 mile run, planned distance 3, actual distance. And I put distance there because I don't know who is going to use miles or what, if they're going to use kilometers. So it's just like a distance overall, and you can base your system off of that. Actual distance, let's say I ran like 2.8. And it took me like, I don't know, like 18 minutes or something like that. So this is what we have here regarding possible workouts that we can be doing. However, if you want to take this and turn it into a daily view, as we always do, we can copy this link here and do daily workout. Oh, we don't need to make that. Put a link database. And change this to whatever we want it to be. I don't think it'd be bad to have a table view. However, I'm a very big list view for a daily view kind of guy. Let's go list here, filter, where date is today, and then change the properties here. So we have the planned distance and reps. I think it'd be good personally. Put a workout type there if we want, and we know what the date is. So this kind of just shows you from a base level what exactly it is that you are doing. Now, if you want to add in the actual reps and actual distance, I think that'd be good too. So then you can see, okay, I planned on doing, and if we can swap these around real quick, I planned on doing 100, I ended up doing 150. I planned on doing 3, I ended up doing 2.8. Planned on doing 5 of those, let's just call them daily planks. Then we have, I did 5 out of, or I did 6 when I planned on doing 5. And that can be the daily view that you put into your daily calendar. I think it's nice to have this in planner, in the daily planner that I have, that view that I showcased earlier. That's something that really works well for me. And I think that anybody who is planning on making a system in Notion that wants to have everything organized like that can really benefit from having this daily view from all the different aspects of their life so that they can get those things done for the day. Now, let's jump into the final part of this, which is the sync that I have with Strava. So as you guys know, the Notion API is great. It's something that's really been awesome for my channel. It's been one of my most favorite videos to make, and has been one of my more recent successful videos, so I don't have a problem ever talking about it. But so when we look at Zapier and the connections that I have made, we can look at my Zaps and we can see that Strava is synced with it, and it has an automated training log. So for you, if you wanted to make an automated training log, you can add a new activity in Strava, choose app and event, go to Strava, connect all that stuff there, and then create database item in Notion. You choose Notion, create database item, choose account, you know, you put your account in there, set up action. So you want to go to the database. So for this case, it'd be called workout calendar. And then you can take the name and put it into the naming convention. I have other different things like other training workout type, but actual mileage is something that's great to go in there. You can have the start date to go in there. You can have the workout minutes to go in there, and then you can have this URL. So if it doesn't hurt, if you want to add a URL to this, I think it's positive to have that connection be made with Strava, as it's kind of nice to keep up with. Obviously, Strava is a great log in itself. However, it's nice if you don't really want to look at the social media app to drag in what you're actually doing. And then this way, it would create a new page, right? And then from there, what you can do is you can, you know, take away this property of what you actually did and just have a page that showed you what you did. And then for me, what I like to do is actually, if I take this table view, we can do something like this. So we can go calculate the actual distance, count all, or sum, sorry. And then what we have here is we have the sum of the actual distance. So for me, I could filter this out to weekly mileage or something. So you can do plan distance or plan distance, or sorry, where the workout type is cardio, right? And then I can get rid of all these different, these views here. And we can just take this and be like, all right, so what was my plan distance for the week? Let me do a sum here. What was my plan distance for the week? What was my actual distance? And then if you filter this further, it's like where date is within the past week. And the same then, so this could be like your running log or something, right? Or you can do something similar and like duplicate this to core log. And then the same goes for the strength log. However, you change these obviously to planned reps, actual reps. Then I got to do to duplicate that and then change it to strength log and filter this guy out to the strength training, and then you're good to go. And that's pretty much all that I have for you guys on creating a workout calendar in Notion that can also sync with Strava.